In this video, we are going to study about the interior angles. You know that when two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, 8 angles are formed, out of which angle 3, angle 4, angle 5 and angle 6 get formed in the interior of the region formed by these two parallel lines, line L and line M. Out of these 4 angles, we can form 2 pairs of angles. First pair of angle 3 and angle 6 and the second pair of angle 4 and angle 5. These are called as pairs of interior angles. As we can see, angle 3 and angle 6 lie on same side of the transversal T. In this case, on the right side. But in the interior of the region formed by line L and line M. Hence, they are called as interior angles. Let us study the relationship between the measure of angle 3 and angle 6. Angle 3 measures 110 degrees and angle 6 measures 70 degrees. If we add their measures, it is equal to 180 degrees. That means these interior angles are supplementary. Similarly, angle 4 and angle 5 lie on same side of the transversal T and in this case on the left side. But in the interior of the region formed by line L and line M. Hence, they form second pair of interior angles. If we measure angle 4, it is 70 degrees and angle 5 is 110 degrees. Let us add their measures. It is equal to 180 degrees. That means these interior angles are also supplementary. Now, we can say that when a transversal cuts two parallel lines, we get two pairs of interior angles such that in each pair sum of their measures is 180 degrees. Hence, the angles are supplementary. To remember the position of interior angles, we can use the shape of C. We can see that these two interior angles lie in these corners of C. Whereas, these two interior angles lie in these two corners of reverse C. Now, let us see what is the relationship between the angles in each pair of interior angles when they are formed by two intersecting lines and a transversal. You can see line L and line M are two intersecting lines cut by transversal T. You know that we get two pairs of interior angles, angle 3 and angle 6 form first pair and angle 4 and angle 5 form second pair. Let us measure angles in the first pair. Angle 3 measures 140 degrees, whereas angle 6 measures 70 degrees. If we add measures of these angles, the sum is equal to 210 degrees. Similarly, if we measure the angles in the second pair, angle 4 is 40 degrees and angle 5 is 110 degrees. Let us add their measures. The sum is equal to 150 degrees. Now, we can say that when a transversal cuts two intersecting lines, we get two pairs of interior angles. But if we look at the sum of the measures of angles in each pair, it is not equal to 180 degrees. That means these interior angles in each pair are not supplementary. Whereas, in case of parallel lines, angles in each pair of interior angles are supplementary. So, that brings us to a conclusion that if a transversal intersects two coplanar lines, and each pair of interior angles is supplementary, then those two lines are parallel. Well, if we have more than two parallel lines intersected by a transversal, how many pairs of interior angles will be formed? Will these pairs also be of supplementary angles? And what if we have more than two parallel lines intersected by more than one transversal? Think about it.